We need to go over your homework here in section 8.4, which started in your book on page 428. And what we were doing in this section, we were dealing with polar coordinates. And we converted from polar to rectangular, wrangler, sounds like jeans, doesn't it? From rectangular to polar. And we also went from polar equations to rectangular equations to polar equations. And then we graphed some polar graphs, didn't we? All right. And you also graphed some polar points, too, didn't you? So that was kind of fun. But let's start in your book here on page 429 with number 43. Now, what you're given here, it says convert from rectangular coordinates to polar coordinates. And our rectangular coordinates here we have are negative 5. Somebody's about to eat a pencil, all right? So negative 5, negative 12, right? So now, what I need to do is I need to find my r. And so we know r is the square root of your x squared plus y squared. So this is going to end up being 25 plus 144, which is going to be the square root of 169. So r has to be 13, right? So we've got our r value. Now we need to get theta, don't we? Now the tangent of theta here has to equal negative 12 over negative 5, right? So if we do second tangent here, of 12 over 5, you're going to get theta equals 67.4 degrees, roughly, right? Now you got to remember 67.4 degrees, this is in what quadrant right here? This is here in quadrant 1. But negative 5, negative 12, if I graph that, that's over here in what quadrant? Quadrant 3, isn't it? Does everybody see how it's going to be in quadrant 3? So I know that this angle in here has to be 67.4. So what would have to be that whole big angle? Add 180 to that, and what do you get? 247.4 degrees. Does everybody see this? Does everybody understand because you're in the third quadrant? So is everybody all right with 43? All right, look at problem number 55. Number 55. What we have here is x equals 3 over y. If I multiply both sides by y, then x times y equals 3, doesn't it? Now, what do we know that x is equal to? R cosine theta, and y is r sine theta. So, right with me. Now, this is going to give me r squared, and I'm going to write this as sine theta cosine theta for just a minute, equals 3. Now, is everybody with me to there? If I come in here and I multiply both sides by a 2, why do you think I did that? Now, what would this right here have to be? Sine of 2 theta equals 6, right? And I would leave it just like that. Is everybody with me there? Now, again, a lot of us get real happy if you can get to right there. Everybody see this one? All right, look at number 57. 57. I wonder, no, do it down here. Number 57, you're given y equals 3x squared plus x. So what's y equal to? R sine theta. What's x equal to? So is everybody with me to there? So what do you think you can do from here? What could you factor out on this side over here? Let's try that for a minute. I have that, right? Now, what could I divide by? R cosine theta, right? Which is going to end up giving me what over here? Tangent theta equals 3r cosine theta plus 1. And I would leave it right there. Everybody see that? Now you could solve for r by subtracting the 1 and then dividing by what? So everybody see, you could subtract the 1. And then divide by 3 cosine theta. But again, I would probably leave it right there. Why'd they leave it in the back? Okay. So is everybody see 57? We all right there? All right, let's look at number 59 here. Same page, number 59. Number 59, you're given x squared minus y squared is equal to x to the fourth plus 2x squared y squared plus y to the fourth. Good Lord. So now, what is x squared going to be the same thing as? Very good. That's r squared cosine squared theta minus, this would be r squared sine squared theta, right? Now, what can you do on the other side here? Doesn't this factor? X squared plus y squared squared, right? What is x squared plus y squared? So this would end up being what? R squared, right? Is that right? Actually, that right there is r squared squared. I'll get it right in just a minute. Is that right now? So now this, what's cosine squared minus sine squared? Cosine 2 theta. And then if you divide by r squared, that one was a little tricky. That made me think. That gave me a headache. Does everybody see 59? All right, let's do number 61. Now, 61 through 67 says convert the following equations to rectangular form. All right, so we ready to do 61? All right, so look at 61. Now, in 61, we have r equals 6 cosine theta. What are you going to have to multiply both sides by? An r. Now we have r squared equals 6 r cosine theta. What's r squared? And what's r cosine theta? X. So 61 was kind of easy, wasn't it? All right, look at 63. We have r equals 2 secant theta, right? Is everybody with me? Now, secant theta is the same thing as what? So, now this would be the same thing as r equals 2 over cosine theta. If I cross multiply, then r cosine theta equals 2. So what do you get here? Could it be that easy? X equals 2? Okie doke. So there we see 63. All right, look at 67. Look at problem 67 there. Right, if you cross multiply, then you're going to have r times 1 plus sine theta equals 1, which would be r plus r sine theta equals 1. Now, what's r equal to? Very good, right? Square root x squared plus y squared. What's r sine theta? Y, isn't it? So if I move my y over, what do you think you could do to both sides here? Square both sides. So I get x squared plus y squared equals, if I square over here, you're going to get 1 minus 2y plus y squared, right? If I fold that out. 1 minus y. What happens to your y squares? So x squared equals 1 minus 2y. That one's a little bit more complicated, wasn't it? Does everybody see this one? Alright, look at problem number 81. Number 81. So get out thy handy dandy graphing utility. And what we have here is r equals 4 sine 2 theta. Right, now everybody put that in at y equals. Now, while you're plugging that in, we know that we should end up having a graph that's going to be what? A rose petal. It's going to have how many rose petals, I should say? 4. Does everybody agree it should have 4? All right, so get your table. All right, so everybody's got that in. I'm going to let you get your table right quick. And we'll see if we need any other points. Now, I don't think I'm going to need any other points. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to let each one of these count as 2 so that I've got 2, 4. And does everybody see that in the halves here would be 1 and 3? Does everybody follow me there? Now, there are other graphs out here, and you can go online. If you go and type in polar graphs, they will give you polar graphs that's got more circles in it than what we have right here. Does everybody understand? You can get them big, small, whatever you want. If you'll look online, you should be able to find some to print some out. So let's see if I am going to need, I don't think I'm going to need any more degrees in here. I think I'm going to be able to work with what we had. So I'm starting at 0, and at pi 6, I'm up here at 3.5. Now halfway there is 3, so I'm at 3.5. At 45, I'm at 4, and then there is 3, and then I'm at 60, I'm at 3.5. Now, is everybody with me there? So what I've got here is I've got a pedal already, and I come back to 0, don't I? Now, remember how we talked about that graph's going to end up curving down here, it's going to go down here, and then it's going to end up here, because the pen's going to just keep flowing. Does everybody see, I'm not going to get right here, stop, and then draw up here. What do? I flow in here, flow in here, flow up there. Does everybody see how it's going to just keep flowing there? All right, let's see if that's true. So at 120 degrees, which is right there, I'm down here at what? Negative 3.5, aren't I? At 135, I'm down here at negative 4. And at 150, I'm down here at negative 3.5. So does everybody see how that pin is going to continue to flow here? And so I come back right there, which I know it's got to go down here next. Is everybody with me here? So at 210, I'm at 3.5. Then I'm at 4. Then I'm at 3.5. Then when I got here to 270, I'm at 0. But when I hit 300, I'm at negative 3.5, which is going to throw me back up here. At 315, it throws me to negative 4. And then at 330, I'm at negative 3.5. And then I'm back at 0. Now, how could you check this graph? Isn't that pretty, by the way? Now, how could you check this graph? Use your handy-dandy graphing utility, right? Does that look like mine? Does everybody see this? Now I'm going to do zoom 5 to make it look a little bit better. Because remember, zoom 5 puts your calculator back in what? A square mode. Isn't that pretty? Don't you like the pedal ones? So we are right here with, everybody okay with section 8.4? Now again, sometimes, and I don't know why I didn't pick one, sometimes remember you have to use your 15 degrees, okay, on some of these. So just remember you may have to do that. All right, so we are right here with number 81. Does that help you some with what you had to do here? Everybody all right here with section 8.4? Everybody okie doke? All right, cool.